Today I'm answering questions about HMOs, questions about spaces that are required for flats, questions about conversions and what you need to do, and so much more. So come and join me. So joining me for the first time, my name is Kam Dovedi, and these questions are from our Premier Property community, and I really hope they help you in your property journey as well. Now, there's questions here from new people and also from experienced people in property. We're going to discuss Melody's question. Melody's asking, if you're the landlord of an HMO, Kam, where utility bills are included in the rent, what can you do to mitigate the recent big increases in gas and electricity? Now, of course, we know, we all know, don't we? How many times have you heard about the cost of living crisis going up? You know, so gas and electric costs, of course, are going up. So what we're doing in our HMOs is that we're either separating out the gas and electric costs, so the utility costs are being separated, and saying to the tenant that you know, because of the cost of living crisis, because the price is going up, you will pay a portion of the bills that come in. So whatever those are, we separate it out. And another thing we've done is we're also checking out some of these intermediate companies where these companies will actually give you a fixed rate for your utility bills for the next 12 months. And then you can reassess the following 12 months and so on. So by the way, that's another great way where you can work on with these intermediate companies. You know what the fixed cost is. And in those scenarios, we've added them in to the rental. So, you know, a couple of things that you can actually test and see what works. A third one I want to share with you is, you know, how you can actually save costs in there. So what we've done is we've made it easier for our tenants to make sure that they only use what they need to use. So of course, you know, they have full freedom to use all the utilities. However, we've put in some thermostats, for example, for the gas. So if someone is not using it, it will turn itself off after an hour, hour and a half's time. And literally they have to just press the button to start it up again. So if someone's left the heating on, they're not at home, and you know, the heating just be wasted, for example, there are these little quick things that you can put into place as well. Electricity, when it comes to electrical lighting, wherever possible, what we're doing, especially in communal areas, you know, we're putting in lighting which will turn itself off, you know, after a little bit of time. So that is also helping. Yeah. So these are the kind of things you can put in place. So Melody, I hope that helps. HMOs still work. In fact, you know, my view is HMOs are the strategy of 2023 because you've got higher income, and because of the stress test, they meet the stress test criteria for lenders. So, and also because of the cost of living crisis, you know, people are downsizing and they want quality HMOs, rooms rather than flats, for example. And that's also helping for the demand for quality HMOs. So Melody's question there, great question, helping a lot of people with HMOs. So let's move forward and, so a question about the Bank of England from Nick here. And I hope you've subscribed to our channel. If you haven't, you can do that today. You can subscribe while I'm reading the next question. You can do it right now. There's a thing whizzing around. And there's that bell icon, isn't there, that you can just click on to get the latest notifications. I'm doing lots of videos and I'm going to be doing even more videos and some videos. Get on with it, Kam. Okay. So Nick is asking, hi Kam, with the Governor of the Bank of England expected to downgrade his initial opinion of the depth and severity of the recession, how do you see this playing out in the regards to the mortgage interest rates? Well, Nick, no matter, my view is no matter what the Bank of England, the Governor of the Bank of England does, no matter who the Governor of the Bank of England is, no matter which Prime Minister we have in place, what we'll find is no matter what they do, the actual market is going to align itself in the same way anyway. So there's going to be peaks and there's going to be troughs. And my view is that we're going to head towards a recession anyway. The scenarios that we got going on in property right now, actually there are some massive, massive opportunities right now, which we ain't going to get for the next 20 years. So if you're watching this video in 5 years' time, you can watch this and remember this conversation that we're having right now. There's big opportunities right now in 2023, and it is really for the people that are well informed. So as you are doing right now. So recession or no recession, it's really the kind of the near the bottom of the market, is my view, and best deals possible that you're ever going to get for the next 20 years are coming up right now. Moving on, we have Salim's question. Salim's asking, Cam, we want to convert a house into two flats. What do we need to take into consideration with regards to fire doors, fire alarms, soundproofing, etc., etc.? Yes. So, Salim, the best way of finding out exactly what you need for your specific stock for that particular property is to instruct building control. Now, building control will be involved anyway if you're getting planning for these properties. And if you're doing the structural changes as you are, building control will be involved. So the way we do this is, first of all, we contact building control. Now, I'm going to give you the whole process. So we contact not any old building control, definitely not the council's building control. We contact independent building control. Why? Because they'll turn up in a timely manner. It will be much more faster because, unfortunately, as you probably are aware, that the councils are very under-resourced at the moment. And in my experience, they say they're going to turn up on Monday and they turn up on Wednesday. Not their fault, just very under-resourced. Private building control, from my point of view, is the way to go. So you can jump in and get a private building control firm to come along, first of all, and assess your project. Once they've assessed the project, they will actually outline for you what actually needs to be done. And then you can decide to work with them where they will actually assess the works as they progress when you got the contractor in. So building control actually will help you with all of this. Now, things that you will find are required, so in my experience. So first of all, when it comes to converting flats, there will definitely be sound insulation in between the partitions of the two flats. There's also going to be fire retardant plasterboards required as well. These are all going to add to your expense. These are much more expensive than your standard plasterboard. Also, in certain cases, there will be special fire retardant substances, I want to call it. So which are around the drainage, for example, where the pipes are and so on. So they normally ask for that as well. Now, if you're going to have bedrooms, as you're going to be creating these flats, you're going to have extra bedrooms where previously there were lounge areas and there are neighbouring properties. Well, they can also ask for sound insulation on the walls, because what their thought is, what they've said to me in the past, is that the people next door are actually living there in the living room. There's a noise impact from that. That's the reasoning behind it. So there'll be sound insulation for that as well. So these are various things that you want to keep in mind when you're actually doing this. So Salim, there's a bit of a flavor there for you. I hope that helps. Gas electric meters, let me add that one in for you as well. Gas electric meters, what we normally do is we will aim to do our best to work with a gas electric meter that is already there. So if it's an internal gas meter, sometimes you can actually tee off that and separate your electrics. However, that really does depend on the electrical survey, and you may find you need a separate connection, which means a bit of a delay of around 3 to 4 months to do that, and they will actually provide a separate connection. And yes, there'll be a separate figure for investment for that to make that happen. So a couple of ways that you can do that as well. So a lot of detail there, Salim, so I hope that helps. You can listen back to this, of course, again. So like what you're doing though, two flats, like it, very good. Right, next question, the final question of the day is from Hesos. And Hesos says, hi, Sifu. Good question, by the way, he's coming up with. By the way, different vibe today. If you're enjoying this, then feel free to subscribe to our channel. You can do this right now. And if you've got any comments, I'd love to hear your comments. So you're here watching this, you might as well comment below. Yeah, if you've got any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you. And answering Hesus's question, what is the minimum size What is the minimum size of an open plan kitchen living room? Are there any minimum room sizes, depending if it's a residential or to let out? So now this is very area dependent, but typically what we find is we will take a flat and we will create it into a flatlet. So what is a flatlet? A flatlet is a flat which is a flat. However, it's also a HMO, but it's not actually a HMO. It's a flatlet which has two rooms, one bedroom that's been turned into two, or two that's been turned into three. And for these types of spaces, what we do is we'll take a lounge and we'll convert it into that bedroom. Yes? So where's lounge going to go? Well, what we do is we'll put it into a communal area, a kitchen and a lounge area. And the key number is 11.5 square meters. Now, remember, like I said right at the beginning of this question, answering this question, that it does depend on the council. However, typically, if you can have a communal area with a kitchen in it that's 11.5 meters squared, then you can create this lovely flatlet where you can add a bedroom in there. Great questions, and I hope you're enjoying the answers. I will see you same place here this time next week. It's Kam Dovedi helping you to take your property investing to the next level. I'll see you next week. Bye for now.